Hi, it's me again with Corel Draw Tips and Tricks. Somebody sent me this graphic of these two rings and asked how to draw it. And I don't know if they mean how to draw the rings or how to draw the interactive, interlocking, what I call it. I'm going to take an oval. I'm not holding down the control button, so I'll get a pretty good size oval. I'm going to hit the plus key on the keyboard, and I'm going to move it over. Holding down the control button, the control button is going to limit my movement. You can either do that, but see, if you let go, you've lost it. So you can either hold down the control button or it'll stop right on the quadrant, or you can hit T like in pop and it'll put them both the same. I'm going to take a 2-point line and go from quadrant to quadrant. That means it's right at the very top tip of that oval. Take your virtual segment delete key and delete that. Come around, delete that. And now you look like you have an oval. I'm going to see how big mine. Okay, this is only less than 2 inches. I'm going to set my nudge factor on like 3. And I'm going to take the smart fill tool. I'm going to use that blue. I'm going to fill that in and nudge it over, fill that in and nudge it over. The reason I nudged it, now I can get rid of my lines. I can nudge it right back. I'm going to take the inside one. Grab my interactive fill tool, and I'm going to go from the very bottom to the very top. And I'm going to add a gray on both ends. Well, I made the whole thing gray because I did not hit the box. So I'm going to take that gray and put it. Now the whole thing's going to get gray, but we can add blue. And that kind of makes it look like a shadow. I'm actually going to make it black. Whoop. See, sometimes if you don't hit that box, it'll color it whatever it wants to color. Now we can make the blue a little more blue by adding more blue. Just put it right on that line. Because we just want a little bit of a shadow at the very top and the very bottom. Now the outside kind of the same. They didn't use much of a color. Interactive fill tool. Let's use a light gray on both ends. And see, by doing that, now I need to bring in the blue again. A couple more blues. And this is where, you know, really your artistic ability will come in, what you think it ought to look like. Because you just want a little bit of shadow. That looks pretty good. Now, Control G to group it, Control D to duplicate it, and rotate it 90 degrees. So, we really don't have enough definition between the two parts. But if we look, this one is on the front layer. So, if we take it and go to Object, Order, back a page, you can't really tell the difference. So I really need to maybe give a little bit more definition. Or let's just try this. Let's just try moving it down a little bit. See, now you can see some definition that this one is actually in front. Let's take this one and go to Object, Order, front of page, and now it took away that. Now what we can do, and I don't mean to make it off center, but that way it works. You can kind of see it better. Might be a little bit hard, but you need to get your corners all together where it's not on a part. I've got it selected. I'm going to shift select this, and I'm going to go up to intersect tool, and I'm going to nudge that out of the way. Now I can get rid of my rectangle. I can take this part and go order back a page, but then I can slip this back over, and it looks like it's the front. Now I don't have enough color between the other ones that you can really tell, but you can kind of see that this is going through. Now, what we can do is we can go to Object, Group, and ungroup this, and we can take this part, get back to the interactive fill tool, and we could put a little, you know, darker color where it looks like it's going in front of that. Anyway, I hope that answered their question, and thank you for watching.